As far as the, you said Tamil Nadu is increasingly theistic. Is that one of the reasons why you think that the Hindutva brand of politics and nationalistic politics is an opportunity for the BJP to actually grow here?
See, actually, kinetic Hindutva is not in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu, in religion, in culture, in value systems, in tradition, in superstition, it is completely Hindu. But it is not politically Hindu. Because the political Hinduism was destroyed by the Dravidian movement. It tried to destroy the religious Hinduism also, but it failed. If it had focused only on the anti-Brahmin agenda, it would probably have succeeded. But when it mixed up God and Brahmin together, the Brahmin survived because of God, and God defeated the DMK and associated movements. So it is the fight between God and the Dravidian movement which resulted in the defeat of the Dravidian ideology. But how can you transform this godliness into Hindutva ideology is a challenge for the BJP. The Ram Janmabhoomi kind of movement won't work here. It has to be a more positive approach. Tamil Nadu has enormous amount of intellectual resources, moral, cultural resources. Even the NPAs will be the lowest. People will repay the debts in time. People will not, you know, in spite of all the powerful anti-North, anti-Hindu, anti-Brahmin movement that evolved in, through the Dravidian parties, not a single person was hurt. Such a massive movement. It's because basically Tamil people were cultured. So you have to make a cultural appeal to the Tamil people. The BJP has to orient itself to a more positive Hinduism, then it will probably work.
Speaking of appealing culturally to the Tamil people, Mr. Gurumurthy, we've seen the Prime Minister recently, we've seen the Home Minister when he was in Tamil Nadu a couple of weeks ago. You know, both similarly expressed regret that they couldn't, you know, make their speeches in the Tamil language. You know, is there a recognition of that bridge that you talk about? Having to appeal to the culture, the spirit of the Tamil people, the Tamil culture?
No doubt about it.
And is there space for it? Because the BJP is looked at as a Hindi party, but they've got these big ambitions to cross that cultural bridge here in Tamil Nadu.
See, when I used to attend political meetings as a student in 1967, I used to hear the DMK people speaking so beautifully in such attractive language in Tamil. I used to find the Congress people struggling to put together four sentences. The DMK won because of the pride of the Tamils. The Tamils wanted an expression for themselves because it's a very ancient culture, it is an ancient language, and that was completely left unattended by the nationalist party, the Congress. I have seen Congress people, Tamil Nadu Congress people addressing meeting in English and that is being translated into Tamil. So you can understand how much they got distance from the local feelings, the local culture. The DMK exploited it, of course, quite wrongly, quite wrong purposes. The attraction that people are now beginning to have towards Modi is because he is recognizing the greatness of our culture. This is important. It may even be political, but more than political, it is necessary to bridge the gap between Tamil Nadu and the rest of India, which had developed in the last 30, 40 years, unattended by the nationalist forces. I think it's a good strategy, and even if it is a strategy, it's good for Tamil Nadu and the country.
Because the DMK still projects itself as the custodians of Tamil culture, the Tamil language, and constantly project the BJP as this outside Hindi party that is only doing this for political gain and electoral gain.
The DMK's credibility has hit the rock bottom. It may win the elections, but it doesn't have credibility. It limited Tamil Nadu below Vindhyas. Then it limited Tamil Nadu below Tirupati. Then it limited Tamil Nadu to the DMK. Then it limited the Tamil Nadu to the DMK, the Karunanidhi family. You must understand how the Tamil mind has been narrowed down to just one family. If they are going to say, we are going to... I have never seen... In fact, I was talking to a Rajya Sabha member from the DMK for the first time having got elected, they wanted to speak to me. I didn't even want to mention the gender of the person. I was talking in Tamil and that person was talking only in English. So after 5 minutes, I said, you realize that I am talking to you in Tamil and you are talking to me in English. He said, I'm sorry. You are completely anglicized at home. Your Tamil is only a formulation. People understand it. I don't think the DMK can rise on the feelings of the Tamil pride. It's over.